The Lost Minds of Phandelver. My name's GM Matt. We're going to begin a playthrough of a module that came with a basic set today. Phandelver. And we've got five players who have, for the most part, never played together here tonight. And what we're going to do is we're going to get started by just giving everybody a chance to introduce their character. Just tell a little bit about your character, their class, if you've got some background you've sketched out on them that you think it's important for people to know, you can add that as well. And then once that's done, we'll get started. So we will start with tell me how it's pronounced. I'm sorry.
Chagwo.
Okay.
He is a human monk. I did write a bunch of backstory, but I got into this weird place where I started talking about like the monk economy, and I don't think that nobody needs to hear that, and I'm a little ashamed that I I do have some stuff there. Basically, he was a sailor, got shipwrecked, turned out that he got shipwrecked on like a monk temple kind of thing, and that's how he became a monk. And now he is vaguely here. I'm not sure how he got here yet, because I know nothing about the setting, so I'm going to figure that part out.
Okay. Yeah, and I'll give everybody kind of a chance over time to kind of figure out and explain how they got into the story. All right, Christina.
Hi. So my character is named Isbrea. She's a human bard. She's pretty much a con artist. She's loyal to who she thinks deserves it, but apart from that, she's incredibly self-serving. And hopefully she will like everybody well enough that she won't be self-serving with them, because that won't be fun. So.
All right, Becca.
My character's name is Xanafi Amastasia. I think that's how you pronounce it. She is a wood elf. Ever since she was 50 years old, which is not very old for elves, she has loved living in her little village and has loved just being in nature and with her friends. And then one day, her best friend, Enna, gets killed, right? By, I want to say I decided it should be a human who killed her. It was an accident, but she doesn't know that. She just knows that a human killed her. So she's really mad, and she wants to go out and get revenge, sort of, but not really, right? Like, she's trying to, like, her friend had always wanted to, like, travel and leave, but, you know, according to their village's traditions, they couldn't do that. So Xanafi just sort of left late one night so she could go kind of live out her friend's dream, that sort of thing.
Okay, very nice. And she's an elf ranger, right?
Yes.
Bow, very, very archetypal D&D character. Very nice. Okay, Lexi.
Okay, so my character is Sinasha, I guess that's how I pronounce it. And she's a half-orc. So she grew up in a super basic half-orc household with a human father and a orc mom. And basically, she just grew up being taught not really orc things, but just to be like peaceful and good and do no harm. And that's kind of her life motto as she just goes along. And that's pretty much it.
And she's a warlock, right?
She's a warlock, yeah. I didn't say that.
Okay. And we'll let you flesh her out as we move along. Okay, Michael.
Okay, I'm playing a dragonborn fighter. His name is Braum, which is short for Braumarok. He is a dragonborn from the Delmarev clan. And he started out as a fighter, defending his village, defending his clan. And one day, his father mysteriously disappeared. No one in the clan knows why. So he set out on a journey to find his father, and along the way kind of ran into a wizard and librarian in the city of Neverwinter who he became friends with. And he's been using that as a way of sort of pursuing an interest he didn't know that he had, which is spell casting and lore and astrology and things like that. That pretty much sums him up.
Okay, and what's his character class?
He is a fighter.
Okay. All right, so our story begins, interestingly enough, in the city of Neverwinter, where you all found yourselves about 2 or 3 days ago. You all had either previously known or had come into the acquaintance of a certain dwarf. And this dwarf's name is... give me just a second. I'm already off to a great start here. Gundren Rockseeker is the name of this dwarf. And he's got this wagon load of provisions that he's wanting you to take to a village that's a few days' journey away that's called Phandelin, Phandalin. And he's agreed, he agreed he was going to pay you each 10 gold pieces apiece, which is pretty nice wages for a job like this, just to take the wagon, guard it, make sure the wagon gets to Phandelin, and then when you're there, you're going to go to a place called Barthen's Provisions, and that's the place where he'll meet up with you again and give you his reward. He doesn't travel with you, however, your dwarf friend. He says he's going to take a warrior escort with him by the name of Sildar Hallwinter. And they're just going to go ahead of you by a few hours. They're going to be on horseback, so they're going to be able to get there a lot quicker than you are hauling the wagon along behind them. And then once you meet up in Phandelin, that's when you're going to receive your reward. So you've been on the road for about 2 days or so out of Neverwinter, heading south. And I'll show you the map of where you started and where you end up. So you start out in Neverwinter, which is this coastal town that's right here in the Forgotten Realms, and you're going to end up in the village of Phandelin, which is down here south in the Forgotten Realms. And so you've been traveling down the high road. These are roads that are known sometimes to have bandits and some various dangers on them. That's part of why he hired you to take the supplies. And you've eventually come and turned off onto a smaller road, and you find yourself at about this location right here on the road. When you come around a corner and encounter a disturbing scene, and I've got your characters all placed on here, but you can set your characters before I describe the scene in any kind of marching order that you like. The one thing you're going to need to describe for me is who is driving the wagon at this point in time. But you can arrange yourselves however you like before we continue.
I'll be driving the wagon.
Do it. I would like to be following alongside the wagon towards the front somewhere.
Okay.
So I'll say I'm like here.
Okay.
How big is the wagon?
It's, let's say, 5 feet by 10 feet. No, a little smaller than that. Let's say 5 by 8.
Okay.
It's got supplies piled up all in the back of it, yeah. All right, so is everybody positioned? Is everybody else on foot? There's room for somebody else to sit up in the front of the wagon with Xanafi if they want to.
I want to sit in the rear if there is room for that.
Okay. Yeah, you can walk along behind the rear, but it's full of provisions.
Okay, yeah, that's fine.
Well, okay. I'll walk the other side.
Okay. All right, so what you come up on is you see in front of you there's two dead horses that are on the road. And in addition to, and they've got these arrows sticking out of them. They look like black feathers on the arrows. And there's saddlebags on the horses. The saddlebags have both been looted. And interestingly enough, you see a leather map case It's laying on the ground about right here. On top of all of that.
Hmm.
Can I tell how long ago they were killed?
Yeah, you can make a... let's make it a wisdom check. Okay. and so for those of you that hadn't played with this character sheet and this dice roller, you get two numbers here, an 18 and then another 18. That actually represents two different rolls of a d20. But if you have advantage on a check, you can take the higher of those two. If you have disadvantage on a check, you have to take the lower of those two. If you don't have advantage or disadvantage on a check, which we don't have at this point in time, then you take the first one. So we're looking at the 18 as the result of this check. It looks like probably it's been about 6 to 8 hours.
How do you do a dice roll again? Like, where do you go?
You can... go ahead.
No, go ahead. It's all right.
Okay. Well, for this one, you can just click wisdom on your scores on the left, and it'll roll it for you.
And if you want to test out a roll right now, anybody that wants to, go ahead.
Do I have to be in my character sheet?
Yes. Yeah, open your character sheet.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and then you just click on wisdom. I don't know why Michael only got one roll on that, but...
There's an option in the character sheet. You can turn that off.
Okay. Anybody else want to try it out before we go?
That didn't work. Ooh, right.
Ooh, natural one.
Yep.
So... Hold on. I don't think I'm doing this right.
Go ahead and get all the nasty rolls out of the way.
It's not letting me click on wisdom.
The actual text, not the number?
Yeah.
Oh!
There you go.
Okay.
All right.
Okay, can I go, like, check on the arrows and, like, see if I can tell, like, who they came from? Like, if it's from, like, a specific group or something?
Yeah, you can make a wisdom check as well.
Okay.
So you're gonna get off the wagon and you're gonna walk up to where you're right beside the horses, is that right?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, you're not able to tell what, with that 12, you are not able to tell where the arrows came from.
Can I go take a look at the map case?
I was going to do that too.
Okay.
All right.
I'll be behind him.
All right, it looks like an empty leather map case.
Where's it at? About right here?
Yeah. About right there.
Have we seen or heard of it before, like when we were talking to him earlier?
Wisdom roll. Go ahead and make a wisdom roll. You can't recall seeing it from when you were talking to him earlier one way or the other. Others can make checks if they want.
I'll go ahead and make a check. Okay. Let's see.
I didn't score any better.
Yeah, so Brulum recalls that this looks identical to a map case that the dwarf Rockseeker not only had with him, but that was being very secretive about, like holding on to, not letting out of his sight, not letting out of his possession.
I think this may be Gundren's map, and I open it up.
There's nothing in it. The map's gone. It's been torn open. It's just the case.
Oh.
Great. Now we're never going to get paid.
Pretty concerned about that part, too.
Oh, this isn't good.
Is it only, like,
money? In New York,
people are very real with their emotions. In L.A., it's Clopax. You know how they say, don't...
Can we see... So the horses are dead.
Yeah.
Gundren's map case is here. No map in it. Can we see if there's, like, any signs of a struggle elsewhere around here? Or any signs of someone...
Or even where they went, like...
Yeah, there's definite signs that... you see scuff marks in the ground and definite signs that there had been some kind of struggle there at the same time that the horses got hit with the arrows.
Can we track their direction, like where they went off?
You might be able to do that, but before we do that, we're going to check to see if any of you are surprised by something that's about to happen. All right, so everybody needs to make
perception.
A perception check.
Would this be perception or a passive perception?
I guess we'll go ahead and do it against the perception check this time.
Okay. Cool.
I think perception is reasonable. We're kind of on guard.
What? Wow. Nat 20. Two nat 20s.
Nat 20s. Okay. Is that everybody?
No. Wait, is that?
It's in the skill list next to the stats.
Shut the front door.
Wait,
two nat 20s.
There's a skill list next to, like, Constitution, Intelligence, Wisdom, Charisma on the left.
Right.
And then Perception is in that list.
Oh my god!
What the heck? Somebody's hacking.
Plus five in that.
So we have three natural 20s on this check. That is astounding. And an 18.
Well, mine was a 13. I get plus five.
Oh, 13 plus five. Okay. All right, so... So those of you that rolled your natural 20s, and only those of you who rolled your natural 20s, are not going to be surprised in the first round of combat. But you see emerging on one side of the woods. Two goblins coming this way.
Uh-oh.
And then from the other side of the woods... There's another one over here. And they're coming out to attack and ambush you. I'm going to roll now for initiative for the goblins. Which I believe is going to be a dexterity-based... Initiative is dexterity-based, right? Okay.
Yeah.
I had a token selected. For some reason, it did not put them into the... Let me try again. Well, you know what? I'm just going to put them in based on that 19.
Come here.
All right, so everybody needs to roll for initiative.
Where do I find initiative?
You're going to hit your dexterity where it says DEX.
No, there's something for initiative specifically. I guess it's probably the same for dexterity, but it's above your hit points.
Oh, that's what you do. You hit the name of the character instead. Okay, I'm going to re-roll for the goblins just to make sure I'm doing this right. I apologize. I'm still trying to learn this character sheet and how it works.
No, me too. It's okay.
Yeah, no problem.
I got it. Okay.
You got the same roll.
Yeah, I know.
That's great.
This layout is so confusing.
Yeah, it takes some time to get used to.
It's
definitely does.
It's really annoying if you have a bunch of spells.
Where is everyone?
Sorry, I didn't mean to do that.
So I don't roll dexterity.
No, you see the initiative.
There's a... It'll say...
Yeah, I found it.
Okay. But it didn't put you in for some reason.
She probably didn't click her token.
Click your token and then roll it again.
Where is my token?
On the map.
On the map. You click your character token on the map and then roll.
Oh, okay. Yeah, there we go.
All right.
Okay, cool.
Actually, wait, I didn't do it right, did I?
Yeah, so we're waiting. Yeah, click your character token and then click your initiative button.
Did you do it that time?
Yeah, that got you.
Okay.
All right, so we got... Is Bray up at the top, and she is one that did not roll a a natural 20, and so she's surprised, so she doesn't get to act on her turn. So now the next thing that's going to happen is that the goblins are going to go, and this one is going to emerge out of the trees here and engage Xanafi and attack Xanafi with a sword. And you want to be looking on your character sheet, Becca, for something called armor class or AC. It should be like the one of the first stats you see on it.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay, what is your AC?
14.
14, okay. So yes. This goblin swings at you and hits you. And you're going to take 5 hit points of damage.
Okay. What do I deduct
this? I didn't even see that goblin.
And then he's going to fade back into these bushes over here.
Right.
And he's just going to kind of disappear in behind these bushes. You don't know exactly where he is now. You know generally that he's located there, but not enough to target him.
Okay.
All right. Now, this one is going to just going to kind of reposition over here behind this bush, and he's going to fire an arrow at Isbrea using a short bow. And what is your AC?
Let me look.
I'm guarantee it's a miss, but go ahead and look.
12?
Yeah, so he fires an arrow, but the arrow just misses. And he's just going to stay there. He's in partial cover behind the bush. And then this one's going to do something similar. He's actually going to... He's going to move up right here. He's going to fire an arrow at Brulem. And what's your AC?
16.
All right. And then he's going to kind of fade back into this bush, and you can't really tell where he is either. So right now, the only one you know definitively where it's at is this one right here, which was too stupid to try to hide after he made his initial attack. And now we go to Sinasha's turn, and you did roll the natural 20, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so what you can do is you can take an action, which includes an attack. You can move up to 30 feet as well. Most of your spell casting also involves is the equivalent of an action.
Okay. Well, I just want to like move to where I can get a good shot at him, and then I'm going to use my crossbow actually to.
Okay, you're already in a perfect place to shoot the crossbow.
Okay.
Well, you could kind of move to about right here, and then he wouldn't have any cover. It'd be a little easier to hit.
Okay, yeah, I'll move to like right here.
Okay, and now you're going to fire at him with your crossbow,
mm-hmm.
which is okay. So go ahead and roll your attack. All right, so now. You're going to roll damage for it because it hits. You see where it says light crossbow +2 at the bottom of that? That's actually a hyperlink. You can click that and it'll roll your damage for you.
Okay.
So you do 5 points of damage to this goblin right here. And that takes him out.
Sweet.
So now we're up to Xanafi. And how did you do on your perception roll? You did okay. You get a turn. Now, you can't actually see any of these enough to target them now. You can take an action to try to spot it, though, which might help another character down the way.
Yeah, I think I'll do that. I'll do that with this one, the goblin closest to me.
Okay. So you are going to make a search roll.
Okay.
You're taking a search action.
Search.
And so let's see how that works. Okay.
Search.
So make a wisdom or a perception. If you have perception, make a perception check.
Okay. Whoa.
Wow.
Yeah. Our rolls are doing well tonight.
So you're able to kind of run over there and spot and say, there he is right there, and point for the next person. So this goblin is no longer concealed.
Nice.
Right. And you've got a little bit more movement. If you want to use it, you can move, try to get back into cover, or you can just stay there. It's up to you.
I'll move back into cover.
Okay. So you could move over into these bushes. You can move over back behind the wagon again. It's your decision.
I'll move behind the wagon.
Okay. All right. Now.
I missed mine.
You missed yours, okay, and Brulum, you got yours, okay. Right?
Yeah, I got mine.
All right.
Okay, so hearing Xanaf call out the position of this goblin, Brulum's going to run over here and just take his pole arm, his glaive, and just stab it into the bushes at this goblin.
Okay.
Two-handed. Stab at thee! Oh, that's awful.
yeah, but it's not. You can see him, but he still jumps away. So you don't hit him.
Dang it! All right.
All right. So now we're back to the top. We're starting a second turn now. Everybody gets to take a turn this time, starting with Isbray.
Okay. I want to do a spell.
Okay.
I'm thinking a vicious mockery.
Okay.
I love
right,
that.
Let's see about this.
I put it in chat.
Okay.
Nice.
So let me know what I need to do.
Your spell save DC will be needed. It's probably like 12 or 13.
Spell save. Let me look.
It'll be on the third tab of your character sheet.
It's going to be 2 plus your probably your whatever your main characteristic is. 8 plus 2 plus whatever your main characteristic bonus is.
Okay. I've never actually been a spellcaster, so you're going to have to help me. Spell save. My spell save DC, there's nothing here, and there's none for spellcasting ability.
Okay, what is your main spellcasting ability? What do you use? You use charisma. Intelligence? Charisma? What's your charisma bonus?
It filled in the information for me. So let me see. I still can't do anything. So my spell save is 13.
Okay. All right. That helps me. So okay. We're going to save a wisdom for 2 goblins. We'll roll for the bottom one first.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Wow.
Then the top one. All right. So both of these goblins are going to take... what is it? 1d4 psychic damage,
and they have damage.
Disadvantage. So let's see if let's auto roll your 1d4. I don't think so.
No, she needs to roll it.
Okay, yeah, so you're gonna roll 1d4 twice.
I think that's how you do it, right?
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh wow!
I said some really mean things.
All right. So these goblins are angry at this taunt, and they kind of come charging out of their cover and it's into full visibility. Goblins are not very intelligent creatures, as you may know.
Said something nasty about their choice of cover.
You have successfully lured them out of hiding, and now it's their turn. So this one right here is going to turn around, and he's going to use his scimitar to attack Brulum.
Uh-oh.
They're rolling pretty well.
Did I do damage to them with the 1d4?
Oh, wait, no. They have disadvantage.
They have disadvantage.
You're right, they have disadvantage. They do not hit. You do not take
nice
5 slash.
Hooray.
I'm really good at challenges.
And this one jumps at Sinasha and does the same thing with disadvantage. But what's your armor class, Sinasha?
Let me see. Hold on. 11.
So it does hit then.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to take 3 damage. Sinasha takes 3 damage.
Okay.
And we're counting hit points down. You count hit points down in this system. So you start with full and then go down.
Gotcha.
Okay. And now actually it is Sinasha's turn.
Okay. Well, let's see.
Now, one thing to keep in mind is your poison spray ability is it's what's called a cantrip, which means you don't use a spell slot for it. You can do it as much as you want.
Okay.
So if you wanted to, I'm not telling you have to use that, but I'm saying that's an option you've got right now.
Okay. Well, we'll try it. Let's see. Okay.
All right. So we're going to do a constitution save for that goblin. What she does is she holds her hand out, and this green spray just kind of comes off the hand to the goblin. And the goblin is going to try to avoid taking damage from that. And does not. And he's going to take one more point of damage, which is actually enough to take him out.
Sweet.
So he kind of, and then kind of falls over after the spray hits him. And that brings us to Xanafi.
Okay, I'm going to attack that goblin, the last goblin.
Okay, you want to use your bow?
Yes.
You can stay where you're at then and just draw an arrow and shoot at it if you want.
Okay.
All you do is hit your longbow. Oh my gosh, is this the third crit in a row?
Yeah.
That's sick. Well,
that's dead regardless of what you roll.
This wasn't happening right now because that means that the next time we do this, I'm just going to get crap rolls the entire time.
Okay, so you not only hit it, you like hit it right between the eyes and it just flies back into the bush. It's done for. And so the threat of the goblins immediately is gone. We're out of combat now.
Nice.
Well done. Just for reference, I believe Vicious Mockery is single target.
Okay, let's...
Oh, yeah, I think you're right.
All right, well, let's keep going.
Let's look over them and see if they have anything.
Yeah.
Okay, you don't find really anything useful to loot off of them.
Well, I'm taking their weapons anyway.
You can toss their weapons in the wagon if you want to.
Yeah, and I'll probably break a short bow out of spite.
Okay.
Is there any like evidence on them that they were responsible for?
Oh yeah, look at the arrows.
The arrows look identical to the ones that are in the horse.
There we go.
Cool.
On our culprits.
And in fact, everybody can make a perception check now.
Perception.
Yes. So everybody that rolls 10 or more is noticing now that you're having a chance to look around. This site has been set up as kind of an ambush site, and probably used multiple times to ambush people coming down the road.
Oh, that's perfect. Okay. Plan. We sit here until the next ambushers come, and then we ambush them.
Sure.
Hmm.
Okay.
The other thing that Xanafi notices is she notices that there is definitely a trail that leads out of this area and into the woods.
Or we just find them and murder them. That's fine too.
and it just kind of leads off to the north.
To the north.
Up kind of in this direction.
Well, okay. If it's for the greater good, I guess we should go find them.
And which way is the town that we're headed to?
The town is towards your east and the south.
Okay.
We just lost Christina.
Well, we lost your video. She's still there. We just lost your video, okay. All.
I'm here.
So what do you guys want to do? Do you want to try to set up an ambush, or do you want to go try to track down these guys?
Set up an ambush? I feel like tracking them down would be more fruitful.
Yeah.
Because, like, we don't know if it's just going to be, like, regular robbers that come.
And it could be days until that happens.
Yeah. What if we killed the last goblins?
This is D&D. There are always more goblins.
For now, when we're like 18th level, that's going to be my thing. I'm going to kill every goblin.
Okay.
Well, I vote we go to them.
Yeah, me too.
Who wants to? So, what does the trail look like? I mean, is it thick or?
It looks like humans could walk on it like double file at best.
How far or how long is it until we would reach the town?
Probably another day and a half.
So I guess my concern is if we go hunting down, the wagon will kind of just be sitting here.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. We wouldn't be able to bring it with us.
Although, if we assume that the goblins were the ones doing all the robbing, then that wouldn't necessarily be a problem. Because we would be going towards them. So
could we maybe try to conceal the wagon some way? Like bring it off the road a little ways.
We have horses, though, right?
Oh, that's true.
Yeah, you've got a horse that, I mean, you could also take the horse a little distance into the woods and try to tie it up or something. But you would not have to make a skill check.
Yeah, that's not a bad idea.
To conceal it if you want to.
Yeah, I mean, other than somebody staying with the wagon, I think that's the best we can do.
Yeah, and I think that someone staying with a wagon is a bad idea.
Yeah,
by themselves, yeah.
Okay, so I would say, like, try to pull the wagon off, like, somewhere down into those bushes to the south, and then I guess bring the horses somewhere in time up in the woods, sort of off the beaten trail.
Could I cast an illusion to, like, I don't know, help tie the wagon a little bit better?
What spell do you have that you want to use?
Let me see. I have...
How long would it last?
Yeah, most illusions don't last more than an hour.
Yeah, if we're going to be gone for longer than that, then never mind.
Okay.
Okay.
So are we agreed, hide the wagon and the horse and then go north?
Yeah, and make sure that the horses have enough food and water for like a day or two.
I mean, they're surrounded by bushes. They'll be okay.
Bushes aren't great at transport.
Bushes.
And also, if they're eating the bushes, they're revealing themselves, right?
They're extremely hungry horses. We come back, all the bushes are gone. What the heck?
All right, so give me a marching order. You can go up to two at a time.
What was the best perception?
Yeah. I'm concerned about
Yeah, I do.
What do you have?
But I'm also low on health right now.
I have a plus +5.
I have a plus +4.
Okay, so I'll go ahead.
Okay.
Okay.
The veterans that have played before know this, but at some point you can decide to take something called a short rest, and in a short rest you can recover some of those hit points. But you may not want to do that yet because you didn't really, on the whole, didn't take that much damage the first time around.
And we also, if we find them, we don't necessarily need to fight them immediately.
Yeah, if we take a short rest, it's going to, we have to take at least an hour and just sit down and do nothing, so.
Okay. All right, so you're marching forward with Zamafi in front, is that right?
No, I'm in front.
I'm sorry, okay. We've got Cha. I will get this right, possibly before the session's over tonight. We've got Cha in front, along with, and only Cha in front. Is that right?
I mean, if possible, I'd like to go, like, individually. Like, single file. I want to scout kind of ahead and then have everybody be marching as a separate group behind.
Okay. That seems reasonable in case there's, like, traps or an ambush or anything.
I also have a +5 to stealth.
Ooh. Does anybody more stealthy want to take the second spot? And I can take up the rear?
I can probably take the second spot. I have a lot of escape mechanism.
Okay.
I have 5 stealths.
Yeah, I'm not stealthy at all, so just put me somewhere in the middle.
If you want to go ahead of me with 5 stealth, although your health's pretty low, right?
Yeah, my health is a little more than half right now.
Well, okay. I mean, ideally, your guys' stealth won't really matter if I'm able to spot them in time anyway.
That's true.
Yeah. Who else has good perception? It would be good to have somebody with high perception in the back in case somebody tries to, like, sneak up on us.
Oh, that's true. Not me.
Yeah, it wouldn't be me either.
I have 4 perception, so...
You have a +4? Okay. That's pretty good.
Yeah, I have a +4.
That is
good. But I could stay in the back.
Okay. I'll go second because I have a weapon that gives me a 10-foot reach. That way, if like we run into something, I can just stab over the top of somebody.
Stab it.
Just stab. Just wildly. Blindly stab.
What's your weapon?
I have a glaive.
Right.
Hold on.
All right, so about 10 minutes down the trail, let's make Chi, let's make a perception check. Okay, so you're able to spot very, very readily there's a snare that's been set in the trail, probably by the goblins.
Okay.
And you can disarm it or just work your way around it either way you want.
Can you describe the snare?
Yeah, it's designed to kind of grab your feet and just kind of lift you up into the air where you're suspended upside down.
Can I use my spear to, like, poke at whatever is holding down the part that's, like, trigger it but not have it grab anything?
Yeah, you can do that.
Yeah, I'll just do that.
Okay, so you just trigger it, and the rope pops up in the air and bounces for a minute, and the threat is taken care of.
Cool.
Our hero.
I did it. I didn't do anything in the last fight. But I
did. And about another 10 minutes down the trail, we're going to make another perception check for Chi. You're nailing those checks.
It's +5.
Yeah. So this time you see what looks like some twigs and leaves kind of covering a pit that's on the path.
Okay, I'll poke this one too, and then be surprised when it falls apart and there's a pit under it.
Wow, a pit. How about that?
All right. I'm pretty sure the next thing is like a rolling boulder, and then we need to all jump to the sides. Or
yeah. No, actually, the next thing is you actually come upon a clearing with an entrance to a cave.
Yeah, like I said, a rolling boulder. Down
the inside the cave is a stone pedestal with an idol.
Right. Yeah, we've seen that one before.
Gotta get the bag of rocks.
Ah, dang it! I left it back in Neverwinter.
Where are we going to find rocks in the middle of the woods?
Yeah, and so there's a river runs out of a cave entrance. You can see the cave entrance right there. You don't immediately see anything as you walk into the clearing.
Is there any sign of life going into the cave? Maybe like the bones of a half-eaten thing, or like a bear that's just chilling, or...
Yeah, you can see like some footprints in the mud along the side of the riverbank, about the right size for goblins. You can see definitely this is kind of a well-traversed area leading off the trail and into the cave.
Okay. When we find them, maybe leave one of them alive.
So I agree with that.
Stuff out.
Okay.
And if no one is able to fight or to deal damage without murdering them, I can, I guess. Because I punch stuff.
Can I see how deep the stream is? Like, can I stick my polearm in there and get an idea of, is it shallow? Is it?
It's going to vary between knee deep and waist deep.
Okay.
Are there piranhas in the river?
Yeah, Xanafi does not see any piranhas in the river.
How about like the smallest sharks? Because that would be worse.
There are no tiny sharks in the river either.
Okay.
I mean, big sharks are probably worse than
crocodiles.
No ill-tempered sea bass or anything like that.
Yeah, exactly. No.
Good. Okay. I think it's safe, guys. I'm gonna try to get closer. So I'm just gonna like kind of creep as quietly as I can.
I want to take a look at the mud around the opening and see how fresh the tracks are.
You're not really close enough to the opening right now to make out something that detailed.
How about the mud that's like near this area?
They look pretty fresh and near that area. They look like within a day.
Okay. Are they both going and coming?
Yes.
Okay. Can I get an idea of how many there are?
more than a half dozen, probably, just based on variation in size and just the overall number. That's just a guess that you're making, looking at it.
Okay. Well, I'll relay that to the rest of the party. We have some idea of what we're dealing with.
Or it could just be one dude running around.
But they're different sizes and stuff.
Oh, okay.
Put on different size shoes, man. You know?
I mean, if they're that dedicated, they deserve it. I can't think of anything else. You guys want to walk in?
Yeah. I say let's go for it.
So how are you going to how are you going to approach this? What order are you going to be walking in? That sort of thing.
Maybe someone who can be a little bit quieter and who is not covered in chainmail should try to creep up and see what's going on. Because I'm brave enough. Braum is brave enough to do it, but he's not stupid enough to do it.
As Chi gets about right here, as he's moving in, I want you to make a perception roll.
I see it.
Yeah. So you're able to make out a couple of goblins, probably goblins that should be on guard right now, but we've already established that these aren't the brightest or the most motivated goblins ever, that are kind of standing in the forest talking to each other. They're carrying weapons identical to the ones that ambushed you, and you can just see them over there. They have not spotted you yet.
How thick is the tree cover separating us?
It's going to provide probably the plus two AC for them. Are you asking for purposes of shooting at them or for purposes of concealment?
Concealment.
It's enough to help on a stealth roll, but like a plus two or so. It's a little bit of light cover that you can use.
If they're just standing around talking, I have the ability to disguise myself. I could go disguise myself and join the combo.
Do it. Please do it.
I just want to kill one and then
no
talk.
I want to learn some stories.
Okay. Get it on the goblin gossip.
If you're going to do that, then I want people to, like, enter the river and then stealth on the tree. Like, climb up some trees and be stealthy. And then if you need to run, you run through the trees, and then they run after you, and then we jump on them.
Okay.
Literally and figuratively.
Okay, so should we get in position before we do all this?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, so how are you going to arrange yourselves?
My end goal is to be, like, here.
If you're going to cross the stream, you're going to make a stealth check against their passive perception.
Can I disguise myself first?
If you don't cross the stream, you don't have to make the stealth check. You can just position yourself wherever you want.
Yes,
you can disguise yourself first, and you can get a plus two on the stealth check, yeah.
So it's this plus two.
Yeah.
I think I'm okay.
Okay, so I guess I disguise myself to look as goblin-like as I can.
Okay, I'm going to look on your character sheet just to see what your ability's like here.
I got you.
Disguise self, there we go. Oh, sorry.
It's all good.
How tall are you now?
Your character. I'm 5 foot, two or something.
Oh, you're taller than me. I rolled really poorly on the randomized height. I'm like 5'1".
Oh, only an inch taller.
So you can make yourself a relatively tall goblin.
a relatively tall goblin is what you're going to appear as. All right, so you've successfully disguised yourself as a goblin.
Cool.
And so we're going to... All right, so we're going to hide in the trees over here by Zhao.
And Zhao, is that your that 21 your stealth roll?
Yeah. Plus, ooh, if you cross the river, you're gonna have to make a stealth check.
Yes.
Yeah, we are.
Anybody that goes across the river is gonna have to make a stealth check, like Zhao did.
Oh, this is gonna be hilarious.
I mean, if you have a bow, that's probably gonna be good enough.
Oh, I'll just stand right here.
I think I'll also do that because I don't think I'll pass that stealth check. I'll just stand at the edge of the river.
Yeah, she's got a nice range. Sinasha has a nice ranged attack. It's a cantrip as well. That chill touch, it's real nice.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm foolishly going across the river.
Okay.
I rolled a 10.
Oh, let me roll.
All right, let's see here. So you're good. You're good.
Oh, wow.
Isbray doesn't need to make one. She's disguised. I mean, they're expecting to see her anyway.
Cool.
Okay. So I'm going to try to climb up in the trees here.
Yeah, I would like to also do that.
Okay.
Do we need to do any checks, or can we just climb?
No, you can just climb.
Okay, cool. Climb.
The stealth check covers you for your efforts to get get in position. All right, so the two goblins are talking. They suddenly look up, and there's this unusually tall goblin that's walking across the clearing toward them.
Oh, God.
And they just kind of stare at him or her and wait for him or her to say something.
I offer a greeting. Hello.
So what languages do you speak?
Oh, gosh. All
right. And what language are you speaking to them right now?
I can actually...
That's a good catch for a first-time DM, isn't it?
That is good, yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, I thought of it just before you said it, and I'm like, uh-oh.
I can comprehend languages.
It does say you can speak languages.
No, it's true. Shoot, that's so... I know I speak common. I didn't pick anything else, though, because I didn't think about it.
You're human, so you get one extra language.
Okay, I'll speak their language. I'll speak goblin. How rough around the edges with me.
So did we just pick your one extra language in the character process? Character building process?
It sounds like
okay.
It, yeah.
All right, that's fine. That's fine.
Matt's going to allow it.
All right. So you say hello.
Hello.
All right. Mm-hmm. And they say, why are you not back in the cave?
Why aren't you back in the cave?
Yeah. Thank you. I say that.
They say, foolish goblin, we're standing guard.
From what?
Preventing strangers from coming into Clark's cave.
Why do we need to be guarding this cave anyways?
And they both kind of laugh, and then they look at you strange, like, to protect Clark and his mighty loot that's inside.
Just be like, why don't you guys just take the loot for yourself?
Why don't we get any loot?
We do get loot. Clark, share the loot with us.
I don't have any loot.
That's your problem. Go back inside cave before you get in trouble.
I feel like I should just go into the cave.
We ask them how much loot they get.
Oh, yeah. How much loot did you get?
They look at you like, you don't know much about this clan, do you?
You know, you're new, you just transferred from the next family.
I just transferred.
It's my first day. I'm new and I don't know what to do.
I'm new. Can you help me out?
They say, go in, talk to Clark, he'll take care of you.
Man, I really should just do that.
Before the spell wears off.
Yeah, I was going to look up the duration.
I believe it's an hour. No, it doesn't tell me at all.
Yeah, it doesn't say what the duration is.
Oh, no, yeah, duration 1 hour. She probably just didn't have it in
or something. Oh, man.
Well, I think we should do something with those goblins before we go in.
I mean, technically, we don't know about this because it's all been in Goblin. So
okay, I'm going to be like, that's true. Can you guys take a break?
Now what?
Why don't you guys take a break?
Okay, so let's do a charisma check.
Oh, God. That's good. Charisma should be your best stat.
I know.
Persuasion, maybe?
Yeah, do you have any persuasion?
Persuasion? I do have persuasion.
Ooh.
Oh.
That's no better.
Still only an 8. For all of this clever dialogue, though, I'm going to go ahead and give you inspiration. So you can go ahead and check that off on your sheet.
Thank you.
They say, no, we stand guard here. You go back in the cave.
They really...
Tuesday, we maybe worked out a signal where she can, like, do something, and then we attack on that.
If she wants to signal back for an attack, she can do that, sure.
Okay.
Is there maybe a way I can distract them so that you guys could maybe get around them or something? Get a surprise?
That's up to you.
Yeah, if you can get them to turn their back or something.
Okay.
Just point to the woods and be like,
yeah.
Look over there for 4 to 5 minutes.
It's Tiamat flying our way.
Okay. Yeah, I'm going to challenge one to rock, paper, scissors.
Do goblins know what rock, paper, scissors is?
They know what rocks and they play, paper are.
The only game they can play is rock. They don't have the technology for the rest of it. So it's constant ties.
So it's like rock, and then bigger rock, and then bigger, bigger rock.
Right, exactly. Yeah. I have biggest rock.
Whoever has the biggest hand.
Rock parchment, rock parchment sword, or something like that. I don't know. Anyway.
Okay. All right. Instead of rock, paper, scissors, a staring contest for their half of the loot.
A staring contest?
Yeah, so they both have to stare. And I think I can out-stare them.
All right. They're just stupid enough to do that and then give advantage to the party in any subsequent combat.
Perfect.
All right, we ready to roll?
Yes.
All right, the goblins are going to be surprised.
Wait, are we fighting? I thought this was to avoid a fight.
Oh, you don't want to avoid a fight.
I thought this was a distraction so that we can get the jump on them.
Yeah. Well, but we already have that, right? They don't know that we're here, right? So...
I am staring at them. I guess technically you could probably walk by while I stare.
What do you guys think?
I mean, I don't know what she's doing.
Right, but I don't know.
All I hear is a bunch of goblin speak.
What if while she's doing that? No, that wouldn't work.
I guess ultimately it's her decision, because she either gives the sign to attack or to, like, walk in or something, right? So.
Well, I want their loot, and they weren't very nice, so I'm going to give the sign to attack.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, then we are rolling for initiative, then.
Ugh.
That was a great roll.
Battle again. Gosh.
Oof.
Okay, oh, that's better.
Oh, you gotta select your character before you.
Yeah, I did it again.
That was such a good roll.
Hey Riley, I think that dog's playing with your sock.
Alright, I'm going.
I think the dog's playing with
I'm
gonna
your assume sock. The initiative tie is broken in favor of the PC. I don't know that to be the case, but I think it is. So that's going to make Sinasha the first one.
All right, cool. Well, I'll go ahead and try out Chill Touch.
What's the range on Chill Touch?
Oh, that's the... Oh, how do I tell?
Let's see. Oh. It should be on the... If you go over to the spell...
120 feet.
Okay, wow. You're good.
Wow.
Okay, cool.
It should be called, like, chill look in direction.
All right, so the goblin is in the middle of this staring contest when all of a sudden this grim-looking skeletal hand reaches out and kind of grabs it around the throat. And we'll see what effect it has here.
1d8 damage.
We're going to go with Lexi's roll and not mine. Sorry, I shouldn't have clicked that. So that's going to be 5 damage. And so he just kind of twirls around for a moment with his hand stuck to his throat and then just collapses.
No.
Cool.
And...
Wow.
Choked him out.
And now the goblin cannot go because he's surprised. He's just kind of looking around like, what's going on? I thought we were having a staring contest, and now we're having, now spectral hands are attacking people.
Did he look away? Because then Christina wins the staring contest and gets
it.
And yes, she wins it fair and square because he's looked away.
So we're going to take it anyway.
All right, so now we're to Brulem.
Okay. I am, to make this even more bizarre for the goblins, I'm going to pull the trident off my back. I have a trident.
Okay.
And I'm going to throw it at the remaining, the still standing goblin.
Okay.
Boo.
So that misses.
Just goes sailing off into the woods. Just,
right, goes sailing off to the woods right beside the goblin. Who is still confused. All right, Xanathy.
Am I within range to shoot my bow?
Yes. You may need to move down a little bit to get line of sight. It is going to be a plus two to his AC because you're shooting through some brush, but
okay.
You can fire your bow from where you're at.
I'll do that.
Well, no, that's the short sword.
Oh, you're right.
It's a shame because that was her fourth.
That was my fourth
crit of the night.
Oh, a dog.
Oh, that's random.
All right, so ordinarily you would have hit him, but you don't because of the brush. This arrow kind of gets stuck in the brush and flies off onto the ground and misses.
Oh, right, because she's still across the river.
Yeah. It's the plus two on the AC that got her on that. All right, this is now we're in Isbray's turn slot.
Okay, so is my disguise self, was that broken, or?
I don't think so.
Not yet. No. Not yet. If you do something hostile, it's going to be, but not yet.
If you want to keep it, we can probably take care of him.
Yeah, can you guys maybe take care of him for me? Because I kind of want to keep it and mess with more people. So.
Okay.
Okay.
So, do you want to run? You want to stand still? Take cover?
I'll just... Will he attack me if I just stand there and look confused, or?
As long as your disguise holds up, then he's not going to attack you.
Well, I'm going to assume it's going to hold up, and my action is to just stand there, I guess.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So now, I'm so sorry. I'm going to get this. I promise. Xia is going to go.
Yeah, I'll leap down from my tree and then get right up close and punch him in the face. Okay, well, that I get to punch him in the face again because that's like monks get to do that as action.
Right, second action. Oh,
I'll do something eventually. Just give me another goblin.
So the goblin manages to duck and dive, and we now start the next combat turn.
Can I use the rest of my movement to get?
Oh, I'm sorry. Yes, you can.
He is now flanked.
Nice.
I guess the other attacker needs to be in melee, though. So.
Yes. All right, so we're back to Sinasha's turn.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to roll my eyes and be like, I guess I'll take care of these guys, too. and I'll just do chill touch again.
Okay.
We'll get them sometime. It's only a matter of time.
So this time the hand kind of appears in front of him and is about to grab him, and it just kind of goes poof and vanishes. And the spell fails.
All right.
So the goblin is now going to turn toward the monk. And let me give you let me reveal a little bit more of this scene here before we.
Okay.
There we go. It's going to turn around toward the monk and attack. Draw its scimitar, and it's going to attack.
Nope.
And it's going to miss. Now we're to Brulum's turn.
Okay. I'm just going to jump out of the tree and walk over to this guy and stab with my glaive. Stab, slash. Please hit.
That is not a hit.
Flanking is advantage, right?
Oh, I'm sorry. You are flanking. You get the advantage. That is a hit. Sorry.
Yes. This is my kill.
In a way, it is. It very much is. So, let's see. That's 1d10 plus 3 slashing.
You can click the...
You just click the name of the weapon, and that does it.
The name of the weapon under your roll?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It's like a hyperlink.
Yeah.
Cool. Sweet.
All right, so you stab that goblin in the back of the neck, and it just falls over. And nice. It is down, and we are back out of combat now.
Let's check their loot.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Rummage.
Is Brea, take one of their weapons, so you're more convincing.
Ah, good idea.
Okay. Nothing useful on them other than their weapons.
They told us they had loot. It's a lie.
Maybe the loot was enlightenment.
Goblins don't seem much for enlightenment.
I don't know. Maybe they're weird goblins.
So, no loot, so we might as well just go ahead and enter the cave?
You should. We'll stay back here.
I will.
Yeah.
Just give us a signal if something starts to happen.
I will do so. Oh, that way.
This is the cave mouth right here. Yeah.
I'm a great goblin.
So you come into the first part of the cave, and there's actually kind of a bank where you can walk along the side of it. And you kind of hear some growling to your right as you approach there. And as you look into that room, what you see is you see two wolves that are tied up inside the room.
Oh, great.
Are the wolves big enough to ride?
No, these are more ordinary type wolves, but they're tied. But they're tied up. This looks like kind of a kennel or something like that.
Yeah.
So they're both on leashes that are kind of staked down, maybe about right there, and they look up at you and they growl a little bit, but they're not terribly hostile because you look like you belong here.
Okay.
You don't necessarily smell like you belong here, but you look like it at least. So they're.
I'm going to use a spell then to distract them. I have, let's see. Where is it? I had one that could create an odor. Oh, here it is.
Okay.
Hoping to like make it smell like cooked meat or something, so they would just like be distracted in that direction. Would that make sense? Or
let's see, you can cast up to 10 feet, so you could cast up to about right here. If you step in a little bit more, you might could get it to about right there.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, not that far in.
Okay. All right, so they both kind of turn around and they're sniffing at the floor, like trying to find something that's not there. They're convinced there's something to eat nearby, but they just can't identify it. So they're definitely paying attention to that as long as the spell.
Should have kept some of that dead horse meat so they would get. My waist horse.
And then I guess I can sort of send a signal for the rest of the team to come slowly up.
Okay.
You want to maybe look at more?
You want me to go in more? Okay.
Yeah, and Alf, from where you're at, what race are you? Are you human?
I'm human.
Okay, so you're not able to see a whole lot. It's getting dark inside the cave.
Okay.
But you are able to see that it moves forward a little bit further, a little bit deeper, with a kind of the bank running alongside a river there.
Okay, so I'm going to move forward a little bit more.
Okay. And you get there, you see it kind of, there seems to be something that breaks off to the left. You can't really see a whole lot more. Again, your vision is really limited in terms of how far you can see because of the darkness.
Okay, I'll go a little bit further. I'm just nervous to, like, end up trapping myself.
Okay. Okay, about right there, I want you to make a perception check.
Oh, God, mine are awful. Perception check.
So you're able to just make out there's a bridge that kind of runs across right here.
Yeah.
And on top of the bridge is a goblin that looks like it's keeping watch.
Okay. And I can get on the bridge from the way I'm walking, or does it look like...
Yeah, I need to describe this a little bit better. Actually, the river runs under the bridge, and the bank runs under the bridge, so you're actually looking up, and the bridge is running across from a passage that's about right here to another passage that's about right here. It's overhead, maybe about 10 feet, 8 to 10 feet over your head.
Okay. I don't know if I should keep going forward, if I should go back and get everybody... I kind of want
to... You will have to make a stealth check if you want to go for... Well, no, you look like a goblin, so never mind. Yeah.
Yeah. What do you guys think?
Up to you.
Well, while she's doing that, can I go find my trident?
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
Okay, I'll go forward while he finds his trident. And not into water.
Okay.
It's somewhere around here. Somewhere around here.
You can see that the cave begins to kind of bend up here. This, as you kind of go under the bridge, it kind of bends off to the right. So your path would, if you stayed on this path, it would kind of go this direction. Under the bridge in this direction.
Okay. I don't know. I kind of want to get everybody because I'm going really far in without the rest of my people.
But you are a goblin.
I am a goblin.
That smells like a human.
It smells like a human. But the dogs don't care. They smell delicious meat. Can they... Let me see. How many spells can I use? That's another question.
Well, so far you've used only cantrips, is that right?
Yeah, and I have another...
That's also a cantrip.
I don't recall offhand. I would think that there's a limit, and even with cantrips, with how many you can keep going at once.
I don't think so. Well, maybe...
No, cantrips, you can just keep casting them, yeah.
Yeah.
Can? Okay. Yeah.
I just have used...
My thinking would be that the theory is you still have to kind of keep in mind what you're trying to get done with the spell. Like,
yeah, those spells have the tag concentration.
Yeah.
But maybe like you can't use the same spell multiple times. Like if you use a spell, then if you use it again, maybe the previous one disperses.
I thought certain spells were like one a day kind of spells. Like a day.
That's not in this edition, except for like monster. Well, I guess it's like racial abilities.
Oh, okay.
Some races have the ability to cast spells, like, whatever, once a day or something.
Okay. Let's go ahead, then. You want to use the message?
Yeah, and I want to let Seanome's character, whose name I can't pronounce, know that they should, that the wolves are distracted and continue forward.
Do you tell me in common or in goblin?
In common. Since only you can hear me and only I can hear you in a message. Then.
What is the range on this?
120 feet, I believe. Okay,
you're good then. You're good.
Yeah.
What was the message? You told me about the wolves.
I told you about the wolves. I told you about what I'm seeing, and that you can probably pass the wolves because they're being really distracted right now. And then I'm going to continue forward, and that you guys should slowly join me.
I'll relay to the rest of the party, and I will tell them that I think we might want to consider some of us moving via the river instead of the path, because it's less likely they will see. They will be watching the river.
Okay.
That's a good idea. So you guys are going to move up river.
I wonder what would happen if we just... What way is the river flowing?
It's flowing out of the cave.
Well, that's too bad.
But I mean, it is a pretty smart thing to do.
Yeah, I wanted to float down the goblin corpses and see what happens. But that seems... I mean, I still kind of want to use them for cover.
We could
feel peaceful.
Oh, boy. I mean, they're small enough, we could probably, like, jump in the river with the bodies and just sort of dangle them in front of us. Like,
yes.
Like, oh, I'm a goblin.
There are your hands.
Does a goblin count as partial cover or three-quarters cover? How much cover can I get with a goblin body?
Not very much. I might give you partial cover. In some
I mean,
situations.
So how tall are they, though, right? Because if they're 3 feet tall, that's 60% of my height.
It's true.
And then the rest is underwater, right?
Because
it's waist deep water. It's just crazy enough to work.
You're just like walking through the river and you can just clearly see just like a full dragonborn head and you're like, oh, just a goblin.
And the goblin's speaking common whenever it's like greeting people.
So are you guys walking dead goblin bodies up the river?
Yeah, I'm going to go grab a... Because Braum thinks this isn't the craziest idea I've ever heard.
If he's doing it...
He picks up a goblin body.
Okay.
Grab these guys.
All right. So
I'm going to go ahead and put my trident and my glaive into their slots on my back and try to walk down this river with this goblin in front of me. Just sort of
now
held up.
Do you have one-handed or two-handed weapons? I know
Cha
does not have any weapons, but Brew.
I have a spear.
Well, you have a spear, but I'm assuming it's not drawn. You're just going with hand-to-hand. So, Brulem, though, are you carrying? You're carrying no weapons right now, and you're gonna have to
not
drop,
in my hands.
And you're gonna have to drop your cover to get access to your weapons. But yes,
yes. Right.
Still drop your goblin.
Yeah.
Or I can throw the goblin, and it becomes a weapon.
In my other campaign, one of the characters, all he does is he takes things, and then he uses them as clubs for the other thing that is. So, like, he would take a harpy and then use it to beat another harpy. It's worked way more than it should.
So, you all can get up to about this point without having to make a stealth check if you want to move in that far.
Well, I didn't see a ping.
Right there.
I'm still not seeing.
There still wasn't
anything.
It's just above the wolf den.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
You might be on the different on a different layer or something.
How's that?
Oh, there it is.
Yeah.
Okay, so I have to be on the objects and tokens layer for you to see it. Okay.
Wait, so can Becca and I move that far too, even though we don't have goblin bodies?
Yeah,
I get the feeling that once they see the goblin corpses, everything beyond, like, they're going to be surprised at that, so maybe it'll help.
All right.
They're going to be horrified at that.
Probably.
That's a form of being surprised.
Psychological warfare.
I feel like he'll just be depressed by her presence.
And just be like, my friends!
Just like, my best friend!
We can go back to the horses and get the other three goblin corpses.
So, that'll take like half an hour.
Don't fall in the pit.
Yeah, don't forget about the pit.
Well, okay. Becca and I can just kind of hang like a little further back then.
Yeah, we'll just stay. We'll stay behind you guys.
So, okay. How far in are you all going with the meat shields then?
I'm gonna go in. How far can I see?
You can see all the way to the end of the cave. You've got dark vision, so you can see all the way down here. You've got the same visibility that Isbrea does.
Dragonborn, no, I don't think I have dark vision.
You don't?
No, I think I have regular old
okay,
vision.
Okay, so your
vision.
I have dark vision.
All right, let's change this a little bit. Let's get someone with dark vision. You can take my corpse. Enjoy.
Okay.
I'll stay out of the water for now, I guess.
Sounds good.
Somebody else take the lead.
All right. I'll take the corpse because I do.
Okay.
Wait. What if I just hold the corpse in front of you and then you're like behind? Because you need...
Like right behind you?
Yeah.
Sure.
So like my logic is you need both hands? I don't know.
Okay. That's not a bad idea.
And I might be better at throwing the corpse at whatever comes. I'm glad that I have to think about this kind of thing.
Okay, that's a good idea. You just go right in front of me, and I'll just follow right behind you.
Okay. And so now Sinasha has a good clear picture of the goblin, good clear view of the goblin that's standing guard up on top of the bridge. Move any further, you're going to need to make a stealth check, though.
You can see him?
Yes.
That means you can kill him.
I can see him, yeah. Are there any other goblins like around that would put...
No, you don't see any other goblins right now.
Okay, well... I guess I'll just try to surprise him. Make a shot or...
Alright, yeah, so what we'll do is we won't go into combat yet. We'll see how effective your shot is because he's going to be surprised. And then we'll roll for combat if we have to. Well, I need to know where everybody else exactly where they're positioned before we do that, though.
Isbrea, you want to get ready to catch a corpse in case it falls into the water by some terrible random mishap that definitely wasn't murder?
So I will stand closer to that slightly.
Okay. All right. You go ahead and make your chill touch roll then.
All right.
All right, so you're going to hit the chill touch weapon thing, and we're going to see how much damage you roll. Okay, so this goblin is kind of grabbed. This time, he's kind of grabbed in the shoulder, and he's trying to brush it away, and it's doing some damage to him, but it does not take him out. He's taking some damage, but it does not take him out.
All right.
So what we're going to do now is go ahead and roll initiative. And I'm going to give everybody else a combat turn before he gets a chance to act. Let me make sure I've got I've got it cleared out. So everybody go ahead and roll your initiative again.
These goblins are rolling really well for initiative, and it's bugging me.
Yeah. Dang it, I did it again.
Yeah, 4. Woo!
Do you want to? Is there any way I can just put mine in there? Because I hate rolling again.
just go ahead and re-roll. We're just re-rolling tonight. Did you get a good roll?
No, I got a bad roll, but I didn't want to be like cheaty. That's better.
Okay, so let's see here. We won't give Sinasha a turn here, but I'll give everybody else a turn in this order before the goblin acts.
What are the aerodynamics of a goblin corpse?
So you want to throw it? You want to run up and try throwing it at this thing?
Yes.
So that would be an improvised weapon.
Yeah. Right, but I'm wondering if I can physically throw it far and high enough, because I feel like the answer is probably no.
Yeah, I'm thinking the answer is no. Okay, I might give you a DM plus. I mean, I'll increase his AC by 6, and we'll see what happens.
How tall is the bridge?
10 feet.
Okay.
You're gonna need to get right to the edge of it.
Throw like a baseball pitcher.
No, what I want to do is, I have the feat athlete, which means that I can use. I don't have a penalty for climbing because it's usually 2 foot. 2 feet of movement is equal to 1 foot of climbing.
Okay.
But I'm exactly 20 feet away from this square, so I can use that and then climb up, and then I'll be right next to him, right?
Yes.
Let's do that.
47.
And I want to kick him into the water.
Okay. Which direction?
Towards the party.
All right, go ahead and roll for damage. All right, so you take him out, and he starts falling off the bridge right toward Isbrea. Just a big roundhouse kick, and he's just done for. So is Isbrea going to catch him?
What do I need to roll?
You have a goblin falling through the darkness towards you right now.
Do I need to roll something, or do I just...
No, you can just catch him.
I will catch him.
I mean, it might not be the most elegant-looking thing ever, but at least you can keep him from making a lot of noise.
I'll be as graceful as I can be.
Okay. And now we have another shield.
Did that break my illusion or no?
No.
Cool.
All right, we're back out of combat.
I hand this to you.
I'm on a bridge. Oh. Can I actually see anything? Different. Yes. I guess I'm human though, so.
Yes, you can see a little bit though. You can see probably nothing that's going to be very useful to you, but you can see the cave kind of going off this direction and off this direction.
Okay.
Huh. Okay. I'm just going to move up to where the action's at.
Okay. Do you guys want to get up here?
Yeah. Can he put his hand down and I do reach?
Like, assist them, give them advantage on their climbs. If it's even necessary, it's only 10 feet, right? So.
Yeah. Let's go ahead and have everybody make an athletics check. But with the assistance, this is going to be a pretty easy one.
Oof.
Gosh. I have a +5 and I got an 8. No bueno.
So everybody gets up there except for Sinasha. She's not able to make the climb. This seems to be a theme with Lexi, by the way. I don't know why.
Yeah,
she can't ever climb anything. Doesn't matter what kind of character she's playing.
Wait, I have tools. I have a hammer and pitons. Can I, like, drop a rope with a handle?
Why don't we just use our goblin bodies to...
I'll just pile them up and climb the... Yeah.
There you go.
So I don't know if that would help. Like, that's not more than a foot, right?
I mean,
well, no, we use them like
prop them up. Yeah, I guess if you prop them up, then maybe.
Like, hold someone, hold them by the wrist, and I'll grab
them
by the
feet, and the other person grabs the hands, and then you just hoist them up. This is getting morbid. Anyways,
yeah. I mean, alternatively, we could just make it like a cheerleader pyramid, and then.
I'm 6'6" or 6'7". I could jump down and like lift you up on my shoulders and push you over.
I mean, if you can get back up, I guess.
I probably can get
it?
Back up.
I'll do it.
Do it.
Actually, your athletics is probably better than mine, but I have that athlete thing, so maybe not.
Thank you.
Okay, so.
So what's actually happening?
Yeah, what is actually happening?
We decide on.
Whoever's going to.
Child's going to jump down and do push her up and then do some monkly stuff to jump back up.
Yeah, okay. Sure.
That's good.
All right, you managed to get her up then. You managed to get her up onto the bridge. So you're all up, standing in various places along the bridge or the entrance to these one of the two pathways.
Now that someone with dark vision is up here, can we see more?
You can now see all the way to a bend. You can already kind of see to a bend right here. And now you can also see down to a bend that's over in this area.
What about further down the lower path?
Oh, yes. You can actually see the path rises up just a little bit as the water kind of rushes out. And you can make out what appears to be kind of a pool at the edge of the pathway down this way. You can see, I'll even make it like that far.
Okay,
so there's some water that's rushing out of but there's a lot of it that's pooled up kind of in this area right here.
Okay.
I think the right path is probably just the way that's intended to get on this bridge. So you guys want to go left?
Yeah, left. Okay. Can I go first? So I can.
Yeah, you should probably go first.
Yeah.
You're going to go this way?
Yeah.
Okay.
Do we want to keep the corpses?
No, I think you're attached to the corpses, but I'm just fine leaving
them. I'm fine with just leaving them. I'm just.
I think we should drop them in the river so they float out of the cave.
That's
a good idea.
Just roll them off, please.
Yeah, okay.
Washing out of the cave, and Isbrea comes around, and do you want to keep going?
Yeah, I'll keep until you tell me to stop. I'll
so
keep walking.
You come into a room and see a gathering of multiple goblins.
Oh, how many can I see?
You can see. Let me get them revealed here.
No, stop. No. Puppy. Oh, wow.
Yeah. So you can see... Yeah, here we go. You can see three different goblins. There's one of them that kind of looks like he's in charge, that's kind of walking around over here. And so there's a total of four of them. Mm-hmm. And then back behind, at the very edge of the hallway... You see somebody that you recognize as Sildar. He is the person that was supposed to be journeying with your dwarf friend to Phandalin. And he's kind of beat up. He looks not in very good shape, and he's sitting up against the wall over there.
Okay.
Is he conscious?
Yes, but he doesn't look very conscious.
Okay. Have they noticed me?
Yes, they have. They've kind of looked up. They're not paying particular attention to it, but...
Are they doing anything, or are they just sitting around?
They're just sitting around.
Okay. Would it be possible if I could be like, does anybody, are they just like, I guess on break or something? Is this like the goblin break room or?
Yeah. I mean, they look like maybe this is just kind of a place where they hang out during the day. I mean, goblin life is pretty boring. They don't have Netflix or anything like that. So they just
water cooler right there.
Are they setting up a retirement party for those two goblins we saw outside?
Oh. It was his last day on the job.
Last day.
Oh. Parts is a ladder.
With the wife and kids.
Jeez. So should I be like, hey, Does anybody want to switch shifts and send one of them out there to die or something? And then lessen the amount of goblins we need to fight? Or what should I do? Alex, stop.
I kind of want you to come back and tell us this, and then we all hide under the bridge, and then you go back and say, hey, the guards outside are dead. You guys should all go check. And then we kill them.
Okay. I'm gonna. Is it suspicious if I just turn around and walk right back? Or
that seems kind of.
Yeah, it's pretty sketch.
Yeah.
I'm gonna call that sketch.
I'm gonna just be like bathroom break, be right back, and then.
BRB. I forgot something.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then I'm gonna go back to the team and be like, there are 3 goblins just chilling, and then a lead goblin, and then. The other dude.
All right, I need to scroll up and check something here. Okay, what's your spell save DC?
I think it's 13, but I'll double check.
It's the same. If it's whatever it was before, what's your charisma bonus?
Charisma is bonus is 3.
Okay, it's 13 then. All right, you're cool. Head on back.
Nobody cares. All right, so now I'm going to go back. Oh, wait, should I wait for my team to assemble or get ready?
Get into position.
Yes.
So how do we want to do this if they're all coming through this way?
Go ahead.
We can all just, like... Would under the bridge be stealthy enough, or would they see us under there?
So I think it depends on how, like, we're positioned under the bridge. So the ledge over here, it's, like, physically impossible for them to see us from their point of view.
Okay.
Right? Like, hug this northern wall?
Yeah, no, I see what you're saying.
Oh, we should stack up the goblin corpses to be on the other side of the bridge. So they'll rush towards it.
Down the river.
You already sent them away.
Yeah, oh, that's gone. True. We already dropped them down the river. I forgot.
What if you lure them back to the bridge and then push one of them over the bridge?
That's like true. Down to the water. I could at least get rid of one.
Yeah, push one, and then I'll be, like, trying to climb under the bridge, and then I just want to grab one, and then, like, let go completely, so then both of us fall into the water.
So when I go back and warn them, I should let them run ahead of me.
Yeah.
And yeah. Then,
yeah. I'll do that.
I'm kind of worried about this area. Like, it might be a more direct path. So what if they just all go out that way, and then we're, like, it's on the bridge?
Maybe. Couldn't I just be like, there's something on the bridge...
Yeah.
Probably eliminate that.
Maybe just as a precaution, I could like be waiting over here just in case they do come down this path.
Okay.
Yeah, if they came out that path, how far away would I have to be like out of their line of or out of their like vision?
You're going to need to be to be out of their line of vision if they come this way.
If they come this way. I don't know if
There's really no way to get out of their line of vision unless you're off the bridge.
I think we're all planning on being off it, right?
Right, yeah.
You're all planning on being off the bridge.
Yes.
So I would say... It really, anything that's off the bridge because it's at a lower level, they're not going to see as they approach. They would have to walk right up to the edge of it before they'd see anything.
But what if they came out the other entrance?
If they came out this way?
Yeah.
They would be able to see... They'd have to get to about right here as well to be able to see people that are standing kind of over in this area.
Okay.
So,
Maybe you should just walk up here and make sure that it's either connected or not.
Yeah, I'll go.
No.
Okay. So you're definitely able to see there's some pretty rough terrain that kind of leads upward through here, but you're definitely able to see clear all the way through to some kind of branch that you're guessing is the branch that Isbrea described to you earlier.
Okay.
This path is going to go downward to the river. This one is going to stay level and go across to the bridge. We're kind of thinking in three dimensions here.
Right. All right, so in that case, maybe it just makes sense to lead them down this lower path, and then we ambush them.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, is that what I'll do? I'll just be like, oh, there's humans in the river or something? Or... Sorry, new dogs.
I guess that's probably fine.
Yeah. I'll just point to that path.
Like, say there's a rich human merchant walking slowly down the river with his fat pockets bulging. So that it would need 4 to 5 goblins to carry all the gold that he has.
Okay, so I'm gonna walk back to them. I'm gonna stand in the doorway or off to the side-ish.
Okay.
And then I'm gonna yell, oh my gosh, I saw a group of rich humans traveling down the river, unsuspecting. Oh, gosh. Do I need to do any sort of check or something?
All right. Go ahead and do a charisma check.
You just told them the truth. That's exactly what's going on.
Plus 10 right.
All right, so they actually respond, humans heading down the river, you're full of baloney.
Should I like start making a lot of noise? Like, yeah. Oh, boy, I wish I could find my weapons.
But it's too deep within all this gold that I'm carrying.
That work?
I think that's a great idea.
Yeah.
Alright, so somebody's gonna make some kind of noise.
Yeah. I mean, too bad it's not in goblin, but maybe they speak common.
Just say gold. I'm sure they speak that word.
Yeah. Alright, so the leader over here, he says, you three, go check it out. And so they start ambling down this pathway right here.
Man, what a lazy dude.
Yeah.
Well, he's going to stay with the prisoner.
I'm going to follow behind them.
Okay. All right. And at what point are you going to attack?
As soon as I see them, I will attack.
Wait. Once we engage combat with these three goblins, you can go and attack the lead goblin now that he's by himself. While they're distracted with us.
Yeah, or at least, like, you don't necessarily need to kill him, because I'm not sure if he's stronger than the others, then you might not be able to.
If they're all bunched up towards the end by the river, could I just, like, football tackle them into it? And then...
You're going to try to kind of push them into it and make them prone on top of everything else?
Yeah.
Okay. let's do an athletics check. See what happens.
Yeah. Probably just hurt myself.
Okay. So they all kind of domino and go tumbling in to the river, and they're just all kind of prone floating in the water now.
Can I get an attack of opportunity as they move by?
No, but I mean, you've got them surprised.
They're surprised, they're prone, and they're wet.
They're surprised and prone and floating on their faces right now. So, nice. But now the disguise is broken.
The disguise broke. Well, yeah. Worth it.
Just say that you tripped.
Yeah.
Oh, the initiative thing. Oh, there we go.
You tripped very forcefully. Oh,
that's I angrily tripped. Oof.
Oh, my gosh. Okay. Is everybody in?
Yeah.
All right, here we go.
I'll take my spear and spear the one that is closest to me. And spear him through the face.
All right,
that's fine.
That takes him out.
Okay, and then I'm going to use my bonus action to punch another one. No, to kick another one.
All right.
And I have advantage, if that helps.
You have what?
Advantage because they're prone.
Oh, yeah, you do have advantage because they're prone, but it still doesn't help.
Okay.
And don't forget, Isbray, that you've got inspiration to give away if you ever want to, or to use.
Oh, I'll give it away to... Did he get the other dude? Or?
You don't have to do it now, but I'm just saying it's there. And plus, he had advantage anyway, so you wouldn't want to use it in that situation.
So could I use it later on the goblin, the lead goblin?
Yeah, you can spend it on your own check or on anybody else's check anytime you want.
Okay.
It gives that person advantage.
Right, yep. And that gives them advantage. But if they already have advantage, there's no point in doing it.
Yeah.
Can I use my movement to get past them to be on the other side of Isbrea?
Yes. You can do that. It's a lot of difficult terrain, but you're not moving that far, so you can do that.
Okay, and that's it for me.
Okay. I'm going to move up into the spot he was in, and I'm going to spear with my glaive this goblin on the right. Just kind of plunge it down into the water as he's prone. Just stab him into the water.
Okay. Boom.
Boom.
Let's see what damage you do. And yeah, so he's just pinned onto the bottom of the riverbed.
Nice.
He is done for. And now we're at Xanafi's turn.
Okay, I'm just going to use my short sword on this guy. Actually, I'll use my bow. Why not?
Okay, you're engaged. Do you want to move back? You don't have to... he's not going to get an attack of opportunity if you want to move back a step. So you're not engaged. Otherwise, you're going to be shooting with distance. Well, no, because he can't. Yeah, you need to step back.
Okay.
But you still miss.
Oh, I do? Okay. Yeah.
No, wait, he's prone.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, she has advantage.
And so you have advantage, so you do hit, so we'll go ahead and roll for your damage. Just click the weapon name on this chat screen there.
Okay.
So it does hit him, kind of glazes past him. He's still able and going to be able to get up and fight, though, when we get around to his turn, which is not now because he was surprised. And now we've got Isbrea's turn.
Okay, let me look. I have a dagger or a rapier or whatever. I'll use the dagger, I guess.
Okay.
Am I close enough? Okay. And having not done damage before, how do I pull that up?
What you're going to do is you're just going to click on the name of the weapon. Do you have an action for the weapon?
No, I don't. Let me find it.
Are you proficient in simple weapons?
I don't know.
Let's see. Let's see what a bard has. It because if we could just roll a dexterity check, I need to know whether to add proficiency into it or not.
I got the entertainer's pack and then I added the normal weapons.
Okay. I'm looking for you right now. Hang on.
Yeah.
Because that's a short sword you just picked up, right?
The stuff I have?
Outside the entrance to the...
Oh, I guess I could use that. I was just going to use my dagger.
Oh, the dagger that you already... Oh, I'll bet you have proficiency with it then. So just roll a dexterity check and we'll see what happens.
Okay. Let me...
Okay, so that's not going to hit.
Oh, well.
So Asbrea takes a swipe at that goblin, but the goblin is able to, well, she just misses him.
Yeah.
All right. Next we go to Sinasha.
Okay. Well, we'll do... I mean, I'm in clear line of sight, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, we'll just do a poison spray.
Okay. It's face down in the water right now, but you can do use a simple action to kind of pick it up and then shoot the spray in its.
Okay, we'll do that. I guess I probably need to move in a little bit. Okay, so I'll flip them over.
Mm-hmm. All right, we'll see what happens here. All right, so that's two poison. So now he's gagging on this poison spray, but he's still going. He's still up and going.
All right, well, that's it for me.
So, we're back to the monk.
You guys have him handled?
I mean, let's see. We've got... He's already hurt. We've got two actions before he comes up, probably, yeah.
And he's still prone.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're probably fine.
Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and move... if I, like, move here, then can I then see the other goblin and...
Yes.
...move to attack him?
Yeah, I mean, you're in the dark, but you can, yes.
Okay, I'll use my spear with both hands. Enough?
That is just enough.
That's kind of annoying.
Why did you roll two damage?
Because I can use it with one hand or two hands, and I specified two hands, so it's the one on the right, which is annoying, because it should generally be beating the one on the left. But whatever.
Okay, so you're doing six damage?
Yep.
Okay. So this one looks a little hardier than the others. You've done some damage to him, but he's still up and going.
And let's try another kick.
Okay.
Probably not.
No. No hit.
Okay, I'm good.
And we're to Brulum now.
Okay. I'm going to attack with my glaive again from where I'm standing. Should be able to reach him from there.
Yeah, you've got reach.
And I'm just going to, like, just come down and just try to, like, chop him in half.
Okay.
Nice.
All right, go ahead and roll your damage.
Chop, chop, chop.
Yeah.
Boom.
Yeah, so that's completely, utterly successful. So there's
finally! Two fighter half, things are happening.
Two half-goblins go floating off down the river along with these right here. And Xanafi's up next.
Okay.
Oh, can I use my movement to try to crawl up after Isbria? And...
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, you can do that. Let's see, about 5, 10, 15, 20, 20, about right near
right
Isbria. Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I guess I'll run over here.
Okay. You're going to have to, because of the distance you're moving and the difficulty of the terrain you're moving over, you won't be able to take an action, but you could go as far as here or here if you wanted to, but you won't be able to do an attack.
Okay, I'll go over here.
Okay.
Right behind the neck.
Okay. And when you use a longbow, keep in mind you can afford to stand back a little distance. You have a 120-foot range, so you can afford to stand back if you want to.
Okay.
Just keep that in mind.
I'll go over here then, because I'm kind of low on health, and I don't want to be his first pick to attack. Or okay. Second. Really?
Okay. So the goblin spins on the monk, and he is going to he's going to attack with a scimitar, and I assume is going to whiff pretty badly here.
Yep. My AC is 16.
Okay. And so now we are to Isbrea.
Cool. So, I'm going to use that. Dissonant Whisper. So the target must make a wisdom saving throw.
Okay. So this is, you're actually using a spell slot on this one, I would assume.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so let's roll 3d6 damage. You know how to do that?
Yeah.
All right, so he kind of holds his hands to his ears, and he just acts like he's going mad, and he finally just plops down and passes out right here from going crazy
cool.
from listening to this sound. And at that, Sildar, we're out of combat, and Sildar looks up at you and he says, "I'm so grateful that you people figured out where we were. How did you find us?"
We followed the corpses that we made.
Our own trail.
Exactly. I can't see that. Oh.
Okay.
We want to know what happened to our dwarf.
You got Gundren.
We want to know what happened to him.
Well, he and I. Anybody else having problems with? Yeah, Becca just popped out.
Yeah,
I did.
Yeah, but we lost your video, but we can still hear you. Michael's
okay.
kind of Michael's a little bit of a problem too.
Okay.
All right. Yeah, we'll just keep going. We're about to have to wind things down, but we'll do a little bit of dialogue here anyway first. He says, "Yeah, we were on our way up the path when we got ambushed on the road. We got drugged down here. I don't know if you realize this or not, but Gundren has two brothers. And they all thought that they had located the entrance to a long-lost mine that's called Wave Echo Cave that's near Phandelin. And they were getting ready to try to explore that cave. That's what the provisions are that you're carrying. But there's a bugbear that leads this clan of goblins. His name is Clarg. And they ambushed us. They brought us here. And I don't really know what they've done with Rockseeker, except that they said they were going to take him to someone called the Black Spider. And I haven't seen him in a day. They took him away as soon as I arrived. But they found the map. Gundren was carrying a map with him. They found that map into Wave Echo Cave. And all I know is they took him to a place that's called Cragmaw Castle, which is supposedly where the Black Spider's located.
What's the name?
Cragmaw Castle, and the name is the Black Spider. He doesn't know who the Black Spider is.
Knowing this game,
does he know?
It's a literal Black Spider. Just, like, really big.
Does he know what condition Gundren was in when they took him away? Like, was he healthy, or did he get beat up?
He had been roughed up quite a bit, but I don't believe he had been permanently harmed in any way.
How much was he paying you?
He was paying me 15 gold pieces to escort him to Phandelin.
Huh.
We're only getting 10.
He's a higher level character than you. Sorry, guys.
I mean, one of us, we did our jobs. We did more than our jobs. And this guy, you know.
Got captured.
Let's finish him off.
I'm planning on continuing on to Phandelin. I'll provide you escort on into
You'll
Phandelin.
Provide us. That didn't go so great with the last guy.
Yeah, I'm sorry. You're right. Would you provide me with escort? I'm not in very good shape. Would you provide me with escort? I'll pay you 50 gold pieces if you'll get me there safely.
Wait, 100. Eat or separately?
Not each. Total, 50 gold pieces.
100 gold pieces, I'll take it.
That's 10 apiece.
I still say 100.
Man.
That's like savings.
What is, I mean, this guy's like all beat up in a cave surrounded by goblins.
Then he can afford it.
Yeah, Kenzo's like, oh wait, can we search the cave for loot and see if we can find any money?
He says if it's loot you're after, Clark is in a chamber that's across on the other side of the bridge. I think he's probably got some.
He says, for this, we're helping.
50 gold pieces is all I can provide you, but I'm willing to hang around or even help you if you want to try to take out Clark. It would help for me if you have some way of healing me. He says, though, he's in pretty bad shape.
I don't think I have anything. I offer him some food. I don't, if he's been here for a day, he might be hungry.
He's probably hungry.
Is he tied up?
He is right now.
I'll untie him and then keep the rope.
Okay.
I'm going to offer him some food and water.
All right. Says very. He's very grateful for it. Says thank you and starts to eat. Kind of as you carry on your conversation.
Is he armed?
No. He's been disarmed.
I'll give him my spear.
But you got a spear. You got short swords laying all over the place too.
Right.
So, yeah, scimitars, rather, laying all over the place. So,
well, I'll offer some emotional support.
All right. Not half-orc not being the first place he'd expect to get it, but he'll go ahead and accept it.
We can do our cheerleader pyramid, and maybe that'll...
All right.
We could take a short rest, and maybe he could
use his hit dice.
Yeah.
Yeah, why don't we rest?
All right.
We can call it on the rest or something.
Yeah.
Okay. So we'll go ahead and stop there. We'll assume you'll have taken a short rest when we start up the next session, which will be 2 weeks on Wednesday night. What is that? July? Is that July? Yeah, July 4, 5,
That's
6.
The
July 6th. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we'll start up from there. And I'm going to go ahead and stop the stream here. You guys hang around just a second, though.